you guys, welcome back again. Today we are going to be talking about caliber conversion in the MDRX. Today we're going to go over specifically the large frame to small frame caliber conversion, and we'll address other conversions in future videos. Okay, I'm going to show you real quick how easy it is to swap this thing from one caliber to another. Right now the rifle is set up as a 6.5 Creedmoor. It's got a 20-inch barrel in it. We're going to swap it out for this 16-inch 300 blackout. So what we'll start by doing is we'll make sure the gun's clear. If there's any doubt, you can obviously pop this cover off and check the chamber in there. So the gun's clear. I'm going to go ahead and leave this off because this is our 308 or 6.5 Creedmoor ejection port. I'm going to set that aside. This is our 223 or 300 blackout ejection chute right there. So the gun's clear. We'll start by taking off the handguard. Loosen these here. There's two of them, one on either side. Flip, loosen those out. And then we just push this push pin through, and then we can pull off our handguard. So handguard's off. Now we can remove the barrel. The barrel's secured by these two tension screws and that lock. So we'll loosen this guy up. This is a torque limiter, 80 inch pounds. You can use this or you can use a 5mm wrench. We'll loosen that up a turn. Then this thing, the barrel lock will rotate 180 degrees. And once we do that, the barrel should be loose. So now we'll pull that out. So there's our 6.5 Creedmoor barrel. We'll pull it out. Here's our 300 blackout barrel. We just reverse the process, slide it in, and seat it firmly. Then we can turn the barrel lock back to the lock position, and then we'll torque these down. Okay, so now that the barrel's been swapped, we need to change the inside parts. Now for the most part, you can just take out the bolt and replace the bolt. Now that we're changed to a blackout, the blackout actually uses a shorter recoil spring, so we're going to change the whole bolt carrier, mainly in the interest of time. So we'll take these two pins out, which will allow the upper and lower receiver to hinge. You could take all three of them out, this one as well, and separate the two. I do this just in the interest of time. You'll notice when you pull this out, it won't come all the way out. You can see that's because it's engaging the ejector there. So when you're pulling the bolt carrier out, you must remove the ejector in order to get it all the way out. So we'll take that out, set it aside. Now we can pull our bolt carrier out. So this is our 308 or 6.5 Creedmoor bolt carrier. This here is the blackout bolt carrier. We'll put that in. Gotta make sure it lines up proper. And then with that in, we can replace our push pins. Okay, so there's our blackout carrier inside. We can then put on our 223 or blackout ejection chute and the ejector. You can't put this on unless the bolt is forward. So as you can see, the bolt carrier is forward, so we can put it on, snap it into place. And now all that is left is the magazine well spacer. This is the 6.5 Creedmoor or 308 magazine. Here's the 5.56 magazine. It goes into here. So in order to do that, we're going to swap out the magazine catch. We do that by pushing in on this mag catch bolt right there and rotating it up. And then it just pops off. It's mounted on a dovetail. So it slides off like that. And we'll put our blackout or a 223 magazine catch on, and then we can rotate it back to position. Now we don't want to put it all the way in yet because we have to put in the mag spacer. When you put this in, you want to put it in at kind of a rotating, see how I curled that in there, push it until it snaps, and then we can install our magazine catch all the way. So now the magazine catch is in position, check it for function, and then our magazine goes in there, fits properly. Now all that's left to do is reinstall our handguard. Down. And she's ready to go there. So now we just took it from a 20-inch 6.5 Creedmoor to a 16-inch 300 blackout. Okay, now I'm going to show you the bolt carrier changes that we discussed earlier. We're going to take the large frame bolt out. You pull the firing pin retainer, then the firing pin and cam pin. You can then swap the bolt out and then reverse the process to reassemble it. On the bolt carrier spring for the 300 blackout, you need to know that the threads are left-handed, so you remove the op rod by turning it to the right and swap the shorter spring out for the blackout, and the longer spring is for the 5.56 or any of the other calibers. Make sure you snug it up to 15 foot-pounds with thread locker. So there you have it. That is your basic caliber conversion from a large frame to a small frame in the MDRX. If you have any questions, leave them below and let us know what you'd like to see next.